Spanish exploration in the 14 and 1500s.
In order to expand the Spanish Empire, explorers and conquistadors searched for new lands.
Various beneficial geographical features worldwide were discovered due to Spanish explorers and conquistadors of the 14 and 1500s.
The explorers typically exchanged large animals such as horses, cattle, sheep, and donkeys with the natives of the land. Plants were also traded, such as coffee, tea leaves, cocoa, and cotton. These plants were also used to make common necessary products.
The explorers encountered many diseases along their journey. These diseases were deadly, fast-spreading versions of smallpox, influenza, and measles. One of the most famous explorers was Juan Ponce de Leon of the mid to late 1400s.
In search of the Fountain of Youth, he came across an island named Borinquen. It was rich in gold, and he later called it Puerto Rico.
The Native Americans bribed Ponce de Leon by convincing him that they would supply him with gold if he sailed to Florida.
When he reached the coast of Florida, the Native Americans attacked him, damaging and sending his ship off course. While searching for an island called Bimini, Juan Ponce de Leon discovered Florida. He explored around the Keys of Florida and later colonized the land.
Vasco Núñez de Balboa was a Spanish conquistador and governor in search for gold.
Balboa's primary goal was to open up new profitable land for the Spanish settlers to exploit, as well as finding a direct route to the Pacific Ocean.
Vasco Núñez de Balboa and Pizarro sailed in search for the South Sea, which is along the east coast of Panama.
During their journey, Vasco Núñez de Balboa and Francisco Pizarro discovered what is known now as the Pacific Ocean.
In 1526, Pizarro left Panama to discover land south of the Pacific coast.
Pizarro eventually reached the Peruvian coastline and landed at the town of Tumbes. The local Indians had never seen Europeans before. The heavily armored Spaniards who emerged from huge wooden ships were like aliens to them.
They live in the sea.
The locals gave the Spaniards gold, silver, and precious stones. They told stories of great cities containing unimaginable riches. Pizarro had found his El Dorado, but had to be patient. This historic meeting of races meant nothing. Pizarro simply ordered one of his soldiers to scout the town for a future attack.
Hernando Cortes was a Spanish conquistador who took control of the Aztec Empire and built Mexico City.
A fellow Spaniard, Cortes, had conquered Mexico and accumulated great wealth by seizing Aztec gold.
News traveled fast, and it was, in a sense, the desire to find something similar or even richer than what Cortes found in Mexico, which persuaded Pizarro and his companions to start probing down the Pacific coast.
Hernán Cortés led a small expedition to Mexico. Landing in Yucatán, he claimed the land for Spain.
Here he gained the power and gold he had been searching for.
Searching for a fortune in the Central American slave trade, 16th century Spanish explorer Hernando de Soto came to the West Indies.
Soto and his men traveled almost 4,000 miles throughout the region that would become the southeastern U.S., seeking riches and encountering Native American attacks along the way.
Great fortune. Responding to rumors of gold in what is now Peru, De Soto invested in Francisco Pizarro's expedition to pursue these fabled Incan riches and joined him as his second in command.
In 1533, Hernan de Soto was sent ahead to explore the highlands, and it's he who discovers the Inca highway to Cusco, which was the Inca capital.
Hernando de Soto is the one that, with a few men, they go to Cusco and defeat the forces there. And that begins, of course, the end for the Inca aristocracy.
Juan de la Cosa was a Spanish explorer who sailed with Christopher Columbus on his first three voyages.
In 1492, De La Cosa and Columbus discovered the New World when they landed on an island in the Bahamas.
From there, they explored the northeastern coast of Cuba and the northern coast of Española.
On the second voyage, they found the island of Dominica in the West Indies and continued to search the southern sides of Cuba and Española.
In 1500, Juan de la Cosa started exploring the northern coast of South America.
After returning to Spain, La Cosa presented the famous Mapa Mundi, which was a map of the known world at the time, making it extremely valuable.
Francisco Vasquez de Coronado arrived in the New World in 1535 as part of the royal court.
After being appointed governor, it was decided that Coronado should lead an expedition to claim the land of Cibola for Spain.
Francisco Vasquez Coronado is known for his discovery of the Grand Canyon, for introducing Europeans to the native peoples of the Southwest.
Coronado searched incessantly for treasure that was rumored to be present in northern Mexico, the mythical seven golden cities of Cibola.
He set out on an expedition unlike any other, covering 1,500 miles to the north of Mexico, coming into contact with the peoples of what is now the southwestern United States, all the way to the middle of the continent, to what is now Kansas and Nebraska.
In conclusion, the Spanish explorers and conquistadors encountered many new walks of life, explored different regions, as well as exchanged ideas and goods.